Hilchos Shabbos, Perek Chamisha Vesim. Here the Rambam is going to discuss the halachas of Muktzeh. He started at the end of the previous Perek, that the Chacham, besides the Isser, which is Midivrei Nevi'im, so the Chacham said that also that your tiltul b'Shabbos shouldn't be ketiltul b'chil, and that's the Yisod of the Isser Muktzeh. Now the Rambam continues, talks about the Din of Muktzeh in the next two Prokem. Perek Chamisha Vesim. Yesh keli shemalachti leheter, v'hu hakeli shemuta lasis be b'Shabbos, davar shenasa le'bechil. The purpose of this keli, which is made for, is something which you're allowed to do on Shabbos. Can kois lishtis be, v'kair lechel bo, v'sakin lachti be basar upas, v'kurdim lefzei be agezim ukeitzim. These are all permissible acts. Yesh keli shemalachti le'iser. You're not allowed to grind things on Shabbos, and therefore these are kelim shemalachti l'isa. So the rule is asoi. Kol keli shemalachti l'heter, ben hoy shel eitz, shel cheres, shel even, shel matches, is mutter l'taltali b'Shabbos, ben b'shvil atzmei, shel keli, Bein letzerech mikeimei, bein letzerech gufei. In these three ways, which will soon take choice. Aber v'chol keli shemalachti l'yisr, bein ha'yishol eitz, yishol cheres, yishol avonim, yishol matkes, is mutter letaltalei b'Shabbos, bein letzerech gufei, bein letzerech mikeimei, aber b'shul atzmi shol keli yosr. It's not humble. A keli shemalachti l'heter is mutter letzerech gufei, letzerech mikeimei, and also letzerech atzmi. That's the chiddush. Asha'inkin, a keli shemalach deliyisr is mutter letzerech gufei u'mekeimei, but it's not mutter letzerech atzmei. What does that mean? Ketzad. Metalkel hu is akair shaleitz lechel bo eleisha b'mekeimei. That's letzerech gufei or letzerech mekeimei. Oy kadei shaleitek konev. You're moving it in order for it not to be stolen. V'zeo b'shvil atzma. You're not going to use it. You don't need the place, but it's b'shvil atzma. V'chein, until t'leisa min achama kadei shaleitivash v'tishover, Emen akshamim kidei shli titpach b'ti posed, hareiz et tiltul b'shul atzmo, and therefore a mutter mipnei shemalach de leheter. So a keli shemalach de leheter, you're allowed to be metaltalit for use. You're metaltalit because you need the place where it is, and you're metaltalit because you don't want it to get stolen, you don't want to get ruined where it is. V'chein, metaltalus tzarichayim e'machteshes, l'shaber alea gezim, elalus alea lamita, v'zel l'tzer gufei. Knows you could take a keli, so we're talking about a keli shemalachti l'iser, you could take it to use, or leishibim kema, or because you need the place where it's lying. Avol einei metaltelo kedei shalei tishover, v'lei kedei shalei tigonim, v'chein kol kietz b'zeh. A keli shemalachti l'iser could only be metaltel, let's say a gufim kemei, but not let's say a chatzmi. That's the difference between a keli shemalachti l'iser and a keli shemalachti l'iser. What about not stamaze to move it, not let's say a chatzmi, not let's say a guf, not let's say a mekemi? So that's not, that's usher even in a keli, that's al Rebbe says, Beferish Shulchan Aruch, that's usher even by a keli shemalachti leheter. If it's stamaze for no reason. Yeah. Now, that's talking about keli. Abevachol she'eni keli, kegen avonim, umoiz, vekanim, vekoiri, sukiyetzvem, it's something which is not a keli. So then, also the taltlan. So over here, you're not allowed to be a taltlan evil, the tzeira gufim akemi. That's the chidush. So if it's a keli, so mlach tilihiter, it could be the taltlan even the tzeira chatzman. If it's mlach tilihiser, only the tzeira gufim akemi. And if it's not a keli, like moist, navonim, things like that, so then you're not allowed to be a taltlan, period. Even the tzeira gufim akemi. Evan gdoilo, oikoira gdoilo. Afopishi nitel is basoris aserbni odm. You need 10 people to carry it. Im yesh teres keli ola metaltron, they say. The fact that it's heavy is not a factor at all. Glossis habayis. Afopishi in kelim. They're part of the bayis. They're a keli. They're made to open and close. Abule huchnu letaltron. They weren't prepared to be moved because they're supposed to be attached. In their normal function, they're attached. Lefichach im nisparku. Afilo b'Shabbos ein metaltlan leisim. So a door that came off its hinges on Shabbos, even on Shabbos, here it says even on Shabbos, is ein metaltlan leisim. V'chein ha'ofer v'hachel v'hames is ein mezizn eisen kemum. Again, because we're dealing with something which is mukta machmas atzme. It's not a keli. It's just mukta. V'chein uben shmein achai is also areu ke'evin. So in other words, anything that's not a keli and it's not a functional item, so all these things are considered muktzeh and they can't be nistaltel for any reasons. And adelis, even though l'chora adelis was a keli, and we'll soon learn that adelis of a keli that fell off, it's not muktzeh, but here since it's adelis of a bias, so therefore it's considered muktzeh. And those can all be metaltel. Halacha zayin. You don't have to be mishtamish with it for its specific function. Well, when we said before that a keli which is malachtel yisur could be used, let's say the gufe, so lechura, this is already nichla. No, a keli since malachtel yisur is let's say could be used, let's say the gufe, so lechura obvious you're using it for something which is not what it's normally used for. And Mamela, Kelish Mlachti Lahatr, Mehechate Sanat. Lachur, I'll call upon him. That's what it says here. Mutal Taltala Keli, Afilu Shalila Tserev Tashmishi, Elelasis, Bemulacha Shalinasil Tashmishi Ketzin, Natal Adam Kornis, a hammer, which is Tanaka nails, and you're using Lefzea Beagazim, you're cracking nuts. Kurdim, Lachti Beidveli, you're taking an axe or whatever, something that's a hatchet, and you're cutting with it a dvela. Dry figs, megera a saw, logba sakvina to cut. A saw is used to cut wood, and here you're cutting cheese with it. Magrefa ligre beis agregris. You're taking a rake, and you're gathering gregris with it. As harachas vesamazlik, you're taking a pitchfork or something you use to winnow with, something that has it looks like a fork. Is lasala echel cotton. You're feeding a cotton with this type of a fork, which is really made from malacha. As a kush, as a karkar, litchibe. You're using a kush. A kush is something you use to make threads, to spin, or karkar is something that the weaver uses. Al kopam the kalim shmalachim leiser. And you're using it litchibe to stick something into. You stick something in, using it as like some type of a toothpick to pick up a piece of a cheres or something to eat with. Machat shel sakoin. A needle that you sew sacks with, so that's also malach leiser. You use it lefter beis adalas, or as a machteshes, which is something you use to crush things to grind, is leishivala. B'chein kol kietzim zeh. Because you're allowed to use all these kalim not for the function that it's made for. Umetaltel adam machet shel yad hashlema little boy sakets. You could take a regular needle which you use to sew, and you take out a splinter with it. Avol imnitl hakotze hanokav shalom. If the part where you put the thread through, that part is broken off. Aya kotze achat shalom, or the sharp part, the kotze shalom of the needle, is a metaltenes, because it's a shevered keli and it has no function. So if you have a needle which you didn't yet put the eye of the needle wasn't made yet, so then you can be metaltel, because sometimes a needle is used to take out koitzim. So if the needle was already made as a needle and then it broke, so then it's considered muktzim. Ashamed if it was never really made as a needle. So you have a needle, pastures, you're going to put an eye in it and you'll use it to sew. But the vila, you could use it for taking out a splinter, and that's also considered something which you're allowed to use. It's not considered a muktzim machmas atzmi. That's like not like an oven. Okay. Halachates. Kol keli. Shemak pedolov, shema yifkusudamov. You're going kalim hamuktsim l'schayra. You have kalim which are made l'schayra. You have a store, and you have kalim in there, and those kalim are there for schayra. You want to sell them. You're not. It's not kalim you're using in your kitchen. Or another situation is kalim hayukarim b'yesa. It's not for sale, but it's very expensive kalim. Shemak pedolim, shema yipostu. And memela, and you don't use it for regular things. You only use it for what it's made for. Is also l'taltel on b'shabbos. V'zehu anikra mukta machmas chsornkis. Something that's mukta machmas chsornkis. In other words, it's mukta because you don't want to lose money from it. And then that's also mukta kigain. Hameser agodl. There's a big saw. Or v'yosid shal machresha. Something you use to plow with. over the sakin shel tabochim, a shechita knife, over cherev shel ushchefin, is a knife that the people that make shoes do make, they cut leather with it, or the chitzin hacharoshim, and again things that people that are carpenters use, or the kurnish shel psamim, something that a special little hammer to crush psamim ukiyetzvam. They're not used for regular things, and they're only used for them. Now, so we have a muktzah machmas chasar kis two eifanim. We have a regular pot, but that pot is here to sell. It's not, you put the pot, it's in the store, you want to sell it. Now you want to use it, so that's considered muktzah machmas chasar kis. Then there's a mtsias of something which you own, but it's a shechita knife. Now you don't use shechita knives to cut challah. But now, so you don't have a challah knife, you want to use a shechita knife. So no, so you're not allowed to use it because the shechita knife is muktzah machmas chasar kis. Now the shechita knife is also made for a dove. It's really keli shemalachti le'iser. It's not clear in the Rambam what happens if you have a keli shemalachti le'heter, but it's only used for a particular heter, not for a particular iser. All the cases the Rambam gives is only when we're talking about it's a keli shemalachti le'iser, and that keli is muktzah chasar kis because you wouldn't use it for anything else. What happens if you have a keli that's malachti le'heter? Ichveis, you have a silver challah knife. It's a special challah knife that you don't use to cut meat. It's a special challah knife. And you use it only for challah. Now you need a knife and you want to use it. Is there a problem? Does that go into a keli of a keli? So the Alter Rebbe says clearly not like that. The Alter Rebbe says clearly the din of a keli muktzah machmas chasar kis is only if it's muktzah for a davar aser, if it would be davar hamutter, so then it wouldn't be muktzah, because since it's not muktzah, because you're going to use it, you can use it for that function. Once you're allowed to use it for that function, you're allowed to use it for other functions. That's the Pashtus Advarim. I think some people are misupik on it because it doesn't say that, doesn't say it clearly here at Al Kopa. Halacha Yud. Kol keli shehuk tzemach musa yisr, osu l'taltalei. Kol keli shehuk tzemach musa yisr, osu l'taltalei. Can gain shehid. So now it's a new maisa. That is, it was hukza because it's osu. Going ner shedliku baby Shabbos. Because you have a ner that's lit on Shabbos, and it wasn't lit on Shabbos. It means it was liku baby Shabbos. When Shabbos started, it was lit. Or v'hamenera shehoya haner ola. Or v'shulchan shehoya olav mois. So you have a situation where you're not allowed to be metalta this menera. Why not? You're not allowed to be metalta the menera because of it's a din muktzah. You're not allowed to be metal to the menera because there's a concern that it'll come with kibui. You're not allowed to be metal to the ner because there's a chash kibui. So right now there's an issur to be metal to this ner. Now, since you're not allowed to be metal to it, so it's called muktzah. It becomes muktzah because of the issur. Now, even though the issur goes, so obviously as long as the issur is there, you don't have to think about muktzah. You're not allowed to be metal to it because you're not allowed to be metal to it. But now that the issur went away, l'mashal the ner was extinguished, or there's no longer the ner on the menera, or there's no longer the mois on the shulchan because the shulchan was the basis l'davar asa. Now it's not anymore because the davar asa is not there. So now we say this new din that's given this katzoy l'bein hashmoshes is katzoy l'kuliyem. That's the whole yisod of this din, the chur of muktzah machmas iser. Now since there was an iser when it came in hashmoshes, so memela, so once that iser was on, so memela that iser is nimshach. L'chur goes together. So there's a new issa called muksumat m'sisa, something that was also the taltle when it came in Shabbos, because not because it was be'etzem muktzah, but because of some reason it was a chash of you're going to be mechabed in there, so that becomes muktzah l'chol Shabbos. Aval keli hamuktzah machmas mius. Kigain ner yoshon shel neft ukli atzei ukiyetzben is mutter letaltulam b'shabes im hutzrechla. So here the Rambam it's over here im hutzrechla. The question is, does it have a din of a keli? No, l'chura muktzah machmas mius is not muktzah. You're allowed to use it, but on the other hand, it says im hutzrechla. First of all, you're allowed to be metaltulit l'tzerich atzman. If you have a rule that a keli shemalachti lehetzer, you can be metaltul l'tzerich atzman. That's shaila number one. And shaila also could be metaltul l'tzerich mekeme. The pashtus. It's hard to believe that you're not metaltul l'tzerich mekeme. But are you metaltel tzer chatzman? That's also a place for discussion. Halacha yud beis. Kol hakelim hanitolim b'shabbos shenisparku d'lal siseyim. You have a kelim that you're allowed to carry, but on the other end, the door fell off. Kigain d'lal sishidit teva migdol. Ben shenisparku b'shabbos, ben shenisparku kedem ha-shabbos. Is mutter l'talten eisen d'losses. You're allowed to carry those losses. V'chein kol hakelim hanitolim b'shabbos shenishbaru. Ben kedem ha-shabbos, ben b'shabbos, is again, shivreihem nitolim. Even though they broke, but you could carry the shvarim. Abavahu shiyeh shivreim oisin me'ein malach. It doesn't have to be me'ein. It has to do some type of malach. Ketzad shivi areva is lachasus b'mespiach chavetz. Even though the areva was to hold the whole things in it, now you're using the lachasus piach chavetz. But that's also it's me'ein malach. It doesn't have to be me'ein malach ton. It has to be me'ein malach. Shivri schuches lachasus b'mespiach pach v'chein kol kietzim zeh. Small pieces that they can't do anything. So then is asur l'taltlon. So that's the difference. The delis habayis, since the delis habayis was never asur l'taltl, so once the delis comes off the bayis, you know, the metaltl, whether they come before Shabbos or during Shabbos. Masha'inkin, a delis of a keli, which the keli was asur l'taltl with the delis. So even if the delis came off, so you're allowed to be metaltl. But there is any shvarim of a keli, which has some type of a function. Halacha yud gimel. Kol kisui akelim nitolim b'shabbos. V'hu sheyesh teiras keli aleihem. Knows it's not just a piece of wood. Knows it's a kisui akelim. It's made for a kisui akelim. So it has a teiras keli aleihem. So the kisui akelim is also, even though they're detached. Hoya keli mechuber b'karka. Kigen chovis atmuna ba'aretz. So here it depends. Im yesh le kisui shaloh. There's a handle to the keli, so it's clearly a cover is metaltel nesa. The lav is a metaltel nesa, because over here, since it's a covering of carcass, so it's more like bottle to the carcass. The chenk, well, looks like it's baina. The chenk yisuya karkois, kigen beiris v'charitzim, is again a metaltel kisi shalem, elim ken yeshli beis achizah. Kisi atanur, afal pishayin li beis achizah, mutal letaltel. Because even though maybe the taner is attached to the ground, but lapel, the taner batsim is a keli, which is not, it's makabotuma, it's a keli. So therefore, as a din of kisuya keli. That's the din. So kisuya keli, a kisuya of a regular keli, as long as it's a shem keli, you're allowed to be metaltal, whether it has a handle or not. Mashayink and a kisuya of something that's karka, chavis bekarka, or a bear. So in order to be able to metaltal the kisuya, it has to have a kisuya that has a handle. Halacha yudalit. Shnei dvarim, echad osu letaltli, ve'echad mutu letaltli, ve'hein smuchim ze lezeh, izeh imzeh, izeh bozeh, and memele, it's in a situation of bizman shemetaltlin echad mem, yitaltl hasheni. So you have two things. One is mutu letaltli, one is osu letaltli. And the question is, and if you're going to take one, you'll take the other. So it depends. Im hoyet zorich ledover shemutu letaltli, is metaltalei, va'aval pi shedover ha'osr metaltalei me. Aber v'im ha'yitzorech letaltal dover ha'osr, is le yitaltalenu be'esu dover ha'mut. So it depends what you want. If you want the dover ha'mutter, so the fact that the dover ha'osr is schlepping zich with is not a problem. But if your interest is in the dover ha'osr, so the fact that the dover ha'mutter is schlepping zich with doesn't create a het. Ketzat. Paga is a fig, an unripe fig. Because in order to become ripe, you put in the tevin. Or b'charara, a cookie, shehoyis al gabi gecholim, is toich from b'kushe b'karkar, you could put something that's spindle, something that has a point to it, and v'neitlin, you take it out, you stick it in, you take it off. Aval b'sha tevin v'agecholim ninorim b'shabes b'shas natila. But your interest is in the dover hamutter, and the fact that the dover osur is getting mistalpul me'elav is not a concern. V'chein lefes its name is shayu tmunin ba'offer retach that was tmunin ba'offer umiktsas olim megulim, and you want to pull it out. There's also again shemtam b'shabes ba'ola shalem. You pull it out with the ola with the leaves that are sticking out of the ground. Aval pisha offer niner. The offer is niner akmanish because lepel your interest is in the thing that the dover are metaltal, and the fact that the dover, which is also letaltal, is schlepping the width doesn't bother us. Abolim hoya fakert, it was a kikir, a tinek, al gabi, So I'll grab your keter, and you're interested in the metalto, the evan and the keter, and so to speak, you're using the kikar and the tinnik as an excuse to be able to be metalto, the evan or the keter, and which is sometimes bemes mutter benegia mes, as we'll learn. But over here, leitalto evan ya keter bekikar ibetinnik shiashola, because over here your interest is in the evan or the keter, and the fact that you're being metalto also the kikar and the tinnik together doesn't in any way permit. We metaltal this evanicator. We can't call kietzvaza. Natal odim, that's a din. Now, this din also applies. Natal odim is bnei, sheeshli gagoyim olof. Here we have a child, that the child is obviously not muktzah, a Yiddish child, and a Gresh child is also not muktzah. I'll call upon the child is there, and he has an evan. The evan is muktzah. So you're allowed to carry the child, even though he's holding an evan, because lapel, you're carrying the child. Avolei dinner, but if he's holding a dinner, you're not allowed to. Why? A separate namitzad muktzah, because there's a concern. Shem yipul ad dinner yitlanu av biyodis. There's a special concern, so that's why you're not allowed to carry a child that's holding a dinner. Kalkola shahoysin nekuva, the sosam nekiv shelo be'evan is mutal l'taltalo. Shaharei nas ha'evan nasus kedoyfen. So the evan is l'chatchila namuktzah. Here is l'chatchila mutal, because you're not interested in the evan. What you're interested in really is in the kalkola. But from deswegen, the evan became part of the kalkola. So mele is no muktzah here at all. Hoysa ha-kalkola malaya peiris. And the evan betecha peiris. And the evan is not a doifan. So the evan is muktzah and the peiris aren't muktzah. And you're interested, obviously, in the peiris. Now, im hoyo ha peiris rituvim, kigein anovim vitutim. And if you're going to spill it out together with the peiris and the evan, so the peiris are going to get ruined. Is no kolosik kmeishu. You take the whole kalkola with the peiris and with the evan in there, because shem yinayir peiris yiton for ba'ofer became hefsed legozu. Became hefsed legozu. L'chur, you have to understand what's. I'm not sure. L'chur, what do we have to come on to became hefsed legozu? L'chur, we said before that if you're interested in the dover ha-heter, the dover ha-heter, and the dover ha-osur is being coming to Mela, that doesn't bother us. So the Chur over here also interested in the Dovera Heter, and the Dovera Yisr is coming to Mela. But vice versa, if you're able to get rid of it, so then you shouldn't do that. That's only a Heter if you have no choice. But if you have a choice, you have a choice. But over here, the Chur, we're saying that's the Vortis. Mokim Hefzeli Gozer, that's not considered you have a choice. There's physically not having a choice. And then there's also not having a choice because it's going to be a hefsed. That's what he's saying. But Malcolm hefsed ligozru to say, look, listen, you have a choice. I'm going to do it this way. I'll be mafsed, you'll be mafsed. So, you know, that's considered as if you have no choice. Halacha yud zayin. Chavis sheshokach evan al piyah. Is mata al tzid of hini fellas. Again, you know, since you have an option of getting rid of the mukta, so you have to get rid of the mukta, and only then you're mital to the chavis. So you can't be matal tzida, and the other option would be to take the evan, would be directly taking the muktzah, that you're not allowed to. Is magbia l'mokimacher, you pick up the whole chavis with the evan on top of it l'mokimacher, and then umatal tzida shaman v'evan ifelus. V'chein the same din hashecheach mois al akar v'tzorech lekar is noyeres akar v'hin noyflis. V'im tzorech l'mkeim akar, so the eitzah of being noyeres akar. And the money is going to be there. It's not going to be a itza because you want to use the place and you don't want the money there. Is netla sakar by moy solov, and you get rid of it somewhere else. That's all talking about if a person was shecheach even al achaviz, he was shecheach the moys on akar. Avol imi niach hamoys me'erev Shabbos al akar, imi niach even al pi achaviz, is areilu asurin l'taltulon, b'afilu nitlu hamoys vo'even without him. Shari nasis l'bosses lover osur. Now, something that became a basis l'davar aser when it came knisas haShabbos. So even though later on the item is no longer there, but that's the muktzah machmas iser that he said before. And since it was aser to talkel when the knisas haShabbos, it remains aser entire Shabbos. Ha'evan sheb bikirviya. Kirviya is the shell of let's say you have a watermelon. So you have a watermelon, you'll take all the flesh of the watermelon out, and you're left with the shell of the watermelon. Now you want to get water with this shell. Now obviously the watermelon, you're going to put it down into a well, it's going to float. So it's not going to really be able to take any water. So you put a stone in the kirviya, so that'll weigh it down. And then it'll be able to go down and get the water from the well. Now the question is this stone, a stone normally is muktzah. And now the stone is making a function. It's helping carry, bring the kerviya down and be able to take water out of the well. So it depends. If the stone is attached to the kerviya to the extent where when you put the kerviya down, the stone won't fall out. So that's fine. Then that then the oven became part of the kerviya. So it's not muktzah. But if it's not attached to the kerviya, even though let's say it could be that the weight of the stone will be able to get the kerviya down into the water. And then when you pick up the kerviya back out of the water, the stone will be somewhere else because it wasn't really attached to kerviya, but it served the purpose of being able to get it down into the well. But from this thing, since the stone didn't really become part of the kerviya, so therefore the stone is muktzah. That's l'chura what it says here. Halacha yudches. Ha'evan sheb b'kerviya. Imimalim ba ve'en nifelas is areya kemiktzis ha'kerviya. And therefore, mutal malizba. Abivim lav, eimim alumba. Beget shalakon, it's to hang on a stick. It's hanging to dry, whatever. Shemtim alakon, and the fact that the kon will move or not is not an issue. Pedis sha'osr lo'ochlam. Kigoin pedis sha'ina musar. Afilo hing chayovim b'maisim edivreim. E maisarishin shali nitla trumosei. E truma tmeya. E maisarishin b'hegdi shali nivdu kilchos. All these things you're not allowed to eat. Is osir l'taltlan, something which is food that you're not allowed to eat, you're not allowed to be metaltlan, it's mutzah. Aval ad-demai, hail the inruin l'aniyam, v'chei ma'isisheni v'heg the shepodon, aval pi shalinosin ha'chemish, aval l'peil is mutzah l'taltlan, because you're allowed to eat it, and you're allowed to use ma'isisheni, which l'inosin ha'chemish, and therefore you're allowed to be metaltlan. Now, metaltlan yisrol ha'truma, aval pi she'in ruy aloy, even though it's only ruy for ha'koyim. Again, it's the principle that we learned before, that if you metaltel a dover amuter, so together a dover also is also fine. Some people have the girsa that faket, b'shehoysa ha-teira l'mayla. V'hoyu ha-peiris m'stanfin b'karka. She'im yinayir esam yipos seidu. Is neir akeli v'netel hatehera eachulin u'miniach hatmeya. The nekudas advarim is if you have something that's tummy and tor together. You have truma tmeya and teiras. Truma tmeya is not roi lachil. Teiras is roi lachil. And they're in the same keli. So if you could get rid of the tummy and be metalto only the tor, so you're now be metalto the tummy. But if you can't get rid of the tummy, because if you're going to get rid of the tummy, the Torah is going to become mastanif. So memelis, you're not going to be metal, or even the tummy will get mastanif. Not the tummy, the Torah will get mastanif, because the tummy is anyways a middle strafa. So the Torah will get mastanif, so then that's a problem. Let's read again the halacha. Metaltel yisrael ha-truma, aval b'shein ruyalei. Metaltel truma t'meya imateir imachul and moyishnei b'keiliach. Bamed varim amurim b'shehoysa ha-teheir l'matalim. And therefore, the problem is, if you're going to spill it out of the keli, they'll get ruined. So in other words, then there's no reason to be able to be metaltal all of it. So the question is, could you get rid of it? So Nekudas Advarim, if the Torah is something which is mistanif, now Lechuri, if the Torah is on top, so Lechuri, just take it out. What do you have to, you can take it out. The problem is if the Torah is on the bottom. The Torah is on the bottom. So Lechuri, if the Torah is on the bottom, so then there's a problem because the only way to get the Torah out is by spilling it out. And if you spill it out, so the Torah, it'll get ruined. So that's the vort. So im hoyu, so the Torah is lamato, so then you can't take it. That's all derech hapshat. So you can't take it. So then the only eitz is to spill it out, and you can only spill it out if it's not mistan. That would be the pashtus hapshat and the girsa as we have. Halacha chafal. But the halvonis advarim is clear that if you could somehow or another get rid of the tmeya and have only the Torah, without making the Torah mistanif, so then that's what you should do. But if there's no such a etza, so then you could carry both together. Halacha Chaf Aleph, not Buch Shel Avonim. You have a row of stones that you could use for building. And on Bibed Yem, you thought about it, or by using it to sit on, is Im Limdum, if you set it up already, you did something to set it up, you made it like a certain straightness, a certain size, is Mutter Leishiv Aleim Lamachar, Abivim Lavas. So in other words, it's not enough that you had in mind, it has to be Limdum, you did something. However, Haroya Shel Dekel, Shagar Don Leitzim, so no, you cut it off and you did things of it to use it as wood, and v'nim lechaleim erev Shabbos liyeshiva. So over here is mutal l'taltlan. In other words, to make charoyah shel dekel into miyachad as a place liyeshiva is easier than an adbuch shel avonim. So an adbuch shel avonim, it's not enough machshava. You need also limdum. Masha'inkin charoyah shel dekel, machshava is enough. The chenim yoshev aleim beid yem is also zichem mutal l'taltlan. Whereas if it wasn't, if you yoshev aleim, so it's mamash, you yoshev aleim. Hakasha l'amita l'yinanenu biyodik. So then it's mutal taltli. So kash is muktzah. Masha'in came, if it's a Michael Behemah, it's not muktzah. V'cheinim hoyol of kari sadnu keitzah ben. Whereas you already put some type of a sheet over this kash. So in Mela, so it's obviously clear that you were meyachar it for sleeping. Is menana biyadish arei nasik mishiyoshev alav bedyen. Hamach, I'm not sure. I mean, luchuri the kasha on the mita. How did it get on the mita? Luchuri, you put on the mita in order to sleep on it. So, I mean, so from that thing, it's considered muktzah unless you put on it a kari sadin. I'm not sure. Hamach is kupa shalafer bebeisay im yichud lekeren zovis me'erev Shabbos. You put it in a special corner. So metaltel b'Shabbos veisay bekol tzrakim because it's obviously this earth is here to be used for functioning. You know, the stam earth is muktzah, but over here, this earth is in a pile and is specially made to be able to cover things of dirt and whatever. Halacha chav gimel. Now there's another din, aser levatel keli mechonim, mipnei shu kesesa. So new din, stam muktzah. There's a din, you know, that make a keli that should become dysfunctional. Ketzad. Leyitin keli tachas aner b'Shabbos, lekabalas Hashem and anoitiv. Why? So Hashem should be near aser letaltelay. The Shem Shibiner is also the Taltalei because it's the Chmukze Machmas Yisr. Chmukze Machmas Yisr, because you're not allowed to take the Shemen out of the Ner because of Mechaba and Memele, so it becomes Mukze. And therefore, it remains Mukze whole Shabbos. So, Kshiyipa Lekeli, Yosr, Tiltala Keli. Show you Mutter. This Keli was originally Mutter Lekaltal. And now it has Shemen in it, which is Osir. It's Osir entire Shabbos to begin Taltal. So, you can't Metaltal the Keli. So you made this keli dysfunctional. Because again, the beitzas atanegelus, so it was nailed to b'Shabbos, is muktzah. There's nothing wrong with covering of something that's muktzah with a keli. So there is a man in the Gemara that says, that ain't keli nitl al davar nitl. So you're not allowed to be metaltel a keli for a davar aser. But that's not the halacha. The halacha is you can be metaltel a keli even to cover a davar aser. As long as the keli itself didn't become a davar aser. Halacha chavdalot. Noisnen keli tachas adlaf. You could put it under a drip. You have water dripping into the house. Vim nismali a keli sheifek v'sheini. Vein and imle. There's a problem to keep emptying it. We're talking about water, which is usable. It's not usable. Why? So because it's a graf shorei, you're allowed to take out. In other words, when you have something that's most, you're allowed to get rid of it. So even though you shouldn't have put the keli there, why shouldn't you put the keli there? Because Lepel, you're not allowed to be metallic. The keli becomes a keli for a davar amos. But lepel, once the keli was put there, and it's a graf shorei, you're allowed to. So the lotion sheinais and graf shorei lechatchila is lechura the hasbara why ein neisna lechura emein roy ein neisna. V'im nosan mutal letaltle b'mayim mamusin shebei shein oisin graf shorei lechatchila. It's not. The Rav is like asking on the Lashon HaRambam, Lechure, this din that the Pale Mamish, Lechatfil, you shouldn't put it there because it's Dovish and Eroy, it's Lechure, Mavat, Kelim, Yechonik. But on the other end, you're allowed to take it out. Why are you allowed to take it out? because lepel, it's a graf shel reya. So mayim amusim, you're allowed to take out. So the she'enes and graf shel reya l'chatchila sounds like it's more on the ein noisna. The rabbi has an arichas over here on this ram. But the halach is clear. You know, kids, you're allowed to, if it's regular water, you're allowed to put it there. If it's not good water, you're not allowed to put it there. But if you put it there, you're allowed to take it out. That's thus core. Halacha chafei. Chavis shel tevel shel nishbara. So here, b'chlal, you're not supposed to be metaltal tevel. As we said before, something that's chayi b'maiser. But over here, you have a chavis shel tevel shel nishbara. So over here is maybe keli u'miniach tachtel to save it. Why? Because it's not mamish adover muktzah. B'chlal, I'm about keli mi'chani, but it's not really so muktzah. Why? Because hail vim over the tiknam the sukkin is therefore areikum sukkin legabi this prat that is there's no problem of being mevatel keli mechani in a situation where it's a tzeirich. The noisin keli tachas haner lekabel the tzeitzis neishem be mamish umutol the taltal keli. So therefore, again, there's no problem of mevatel keli mechani. Koira shenishbara, you have a beam in the roof that got broken. Because if you're going to put a long bench, and you're going to put it up, you know, vertically, and to hold up the beams, you shouldn't crack. The beam is cracking. You want to hold it up. So if you put it up there, so the concern is if you're going to put it in tight, so you can't move the bench anymore. You can't move this piece of wood that you're putting there, which was originally mutter to be metaltal, so you're being mevatal keli meichane. That's what he's saying. Nochamal koira shenishbara in same chaneisa besavsel e baruchas amita elim kein hoyu revachim. Unless there was space, you know, as you're putting it there, you don't want to think the plots down. But right now, the violet is still space. The cholzman sheyichpeitz at this point in time yitlin kadeishal yevatal keli meichane. So if it plots, it'll taka have a problem. But lapel, right now you're not being mavatal a keli meichane. Mashenkin, if you're going to put it in tightly, so immediately you're causing a keli to become ois keli, and you, not because lechuri, not because of mukta. So there's another din. Normally the din of ein mavatal keli meichane is because you're getting something mukta to go on it. Over here you're being mavatal keli meichane because you're putting it in a position where you can't take it out. You're not allowed to take it out. You can't take it out. Person machzelus al gabi avonim b'shabes al gabi kaveres dveirim b'chama mpnei achama or b'kshamim mpnei akshamim. Knows you want to protect it from the heat or from the rain. A bebulvad shul yischaven lotzut. When you put it on top of a kaveres, you shouldn't have kavana to fatzeda of the dveirim. Shari netel b'chalei sheyirtzes. So since you could take this machzelus off. So mele doesn't go into the gather of mevatel keli meichane. You're putting the machzelus on and you can take it off. So how is it the mevatel keli meichane? The kefen is asal b'shabes lefnei afreichim b'shul shiyalol v'yerdu. Shari mutal etatulik sheyerdim yole v'chein kol kietz b'zeh. These tanagilim aren't going to remain there. They're going to go up and they can go down. So while they're up, you can't talk in metal it. But since they're eventually going to go down, so that's not considered. Again, we're learning the dinam of mevatel keli meichane. Behema shenoflu halacha chova. Behema shenoflu lebeder la'amis hamayim. Is im yochel litlo parnosa b'mekema. You can bring it food, whatever it needs, where it is, and it could be there all Shabbos, and nothing will happen. Mefarnes neis ad mitzvay Shabbos. Abeviim lav. You're not going to somehow or another. You're not going to be able to put food there. It says maybe the behema might die, or the behema will be in a great pain, distress. Is maybe karim uksosis umeniach tachter. You could put all kinds of pillows and things, blankets there. And the male of him also, the behemoth will be able to use all these pillows to be able to go up. They'll be fine. I b'aval pishem avatel keli meichane. But you're taking these pillows and you're throwing it into a bear with water. Shari mashlicha lebear techamay. And lechura, how you're allowed to do it? We say you're allowed to mevatel keli meichane. So the answer is mipnei tzar balichayim legozu. But osur la'leisa b'yodi. But to take the animal with your hands, the animal's muktzis. You're not allowed to carry it up. Whereas even Tsar Bali Chaim doesn't justify it. You're not allowed to pick up a behemoth v'chayi v'eif b'chatzah. There's no shayla of carrying, but you're not allowed to carry a behemoth. You're allowed to push it in order for the behemoth to go in. That's not called carrying it. You could support, in other words, when the behemoth is walking, you could like support it. You're supporting it with both hands. an egel, a calf, and sayochim, a ponies, young ponies, you can help them walk. However, tarnegel shebarcha, if you have a chicken that ran away, emedad nesa, you're not allowed to support it, mipnei shehin shmetis, because it's going to pull away, minayad, v'nimtza agapen etloshim, you're going to pull its wing, its feathers off, and you're pulling feathers, you're taking feathers off the chicken on Shabbos. Notice to push it from the back, that's fine, but to support it by holding it with your hands, that would be awesome, because we're concerned that the tarnagels will start flying away, and then you'll hold it, and you'll be pulling out some of its feathers.